Now we will see about next tutorial regarding part 7 using built-in trigger and push button and win button. So this tutorial covers the following topic: built-in trigger. What is the difference between input item and non-input item? Push button. Under push button we see what is tooltip color, how to change the color, for color and background color of the push button. Win button, pressed trigger. This information is. First, we will see what is called trigger. Triggers are special programs are used to define constraints. These are stored in user triggers. These are executed automatically according to the event slicing, then statement performed. These are also called event-driven programming. Advantages of trigger is nothing but auto management of data, auditing of records, validations. This is the advantages of trigger. So, what are the sample of some built-in triggers are previous underscore record, next underscore record, first underscore record, clear record, update record, commit form, commit, execute query, next underscore item, enter query, this and all called the built-in. Some opening the form, open form, call form, new form, everything. Gradually we use all built-in triggers in our following tutorials and other we can use it slowly. We can use almost everything. So, what is input item? What is non-input item? Still in the previous part, we covered text item. Text item, input item, radio button, checkbox, list item. All are input items. Why we call input item is nothing but these all are related to the database. All are connected with the database, correspond to the database. And another one, we can type. We can navigate. It is possible to navigate in runtime. Text item we can type. We can select the radio button. We can select the list item. We can select from the list item. The database information we can select through the list item. That's why we can navigate in the runtime. All text input items are, we can navigate in the runtime. It is a database. So that's why it is called the input item. Non-input items are push button, images, display items are non-input items. It is not possible to navigate in the runtime. You can just click. You can click the push button. That's all. You can't able to type. You can't able to insert to the database and all. Images also like. You can press the image. You can activate the image. It is a non-input. So, this is called non-database items are called non-input items. So, what is push button? We'll see what is push button. Push button is an interface object that you can click and initiate. Whenever you press the button, click the button, we can do the activity. That action through what? Triggers. Triggers. Suppose we are, I'll press the previous button, it will go to the previous record. If I press next button, it will go to the next record. If I want to clear before, it will clear. That action depends upon the trigger what I am writing for that push button. The push button is usually displayed as a rectangle with descriptive label inside. It has the label or name. So push button cannot store or display values because it is non-input item. So you can enhance your form module by adding push button to provide quick and direct access. Two type of style of push button. Text button, we will see text button only, iconic button. But we are covering only the text button. What are the actions we can do using the button? Nothing but moving the input focus, displaying the LOB, invoking editor, invoke other window, committing a data, issuing a query, performing calculations. This and all possible whenever we do the various actions of the. And we already covered hint in my text item, I think part 3 of the tutorial. But what is the difference between the hint and tooltip? Generally, we use tooltip for buttons. For example, suppose I will go and place my mouse. Just I will place my mouse. Bold is coming. You can see italic coming. Underline it coming. This way it will come in the here you can see print preview. You can see print. This is all called tooltip. Whenever your mouse will be placed, automatically information will come. That is called tooltip. It will display within the window. The runtime, whenever I place the mouse in the push button or whatever the item, it is immediately coming is called the tooltip information or tooltip messages. When just to place the mouse in the appropriate item itself, the toolkit information will display in the window. This is very important. But in the hint, it will display in the status bar, like a message field. Whenever input focus, whenever I click the mouse, here no need to click, just to place it. So this is not there. If you click the mouse, the cursor should be placed. Then only the message will come. It is like a message screen. That is the difference between hint and then toolkit in the properties. That also will be. So this is what our part 7. Now we can put the form. The form, this is our form. Now I want to create one push button. So I want to create a push button. What I will do is, here is a button. I will click the button and generally, it will come 4. Why it is coming 4 is where that button created in the push block. Push block, how many records? Number of records? 4. That's why it's coming. The two way we can reduce to 1. One is this way. We can go to the property palette and we change number of items displayed to be 1. This way we can see. Now it becomes 1. This is the one method. And delete it. Delete the record. Another method is nothing but just to keep the record. Now this way is done. What I will do is, instead of doing this record, I will just push it to this block. Automatically it becomes only one button. Because I want to execute only this. According to this execution, here my detail block will display. So that's why I am placing the push button here. Most of the people will do the mistake. They will place the push button in the detail block, not in the master block. Generally, we make push button in the master block. That is a good one, because if you execute query, if you execute this, automatically it will also execute. So no need to write execute for this. If my push button is available in the detail block, it will execute only the detail block, that is book information, not author information. But my push button in author information, if I write execute query, automatically it will come. That is what master detail relationship. Now what I will do is, I will go to the property palette. I will change the name. Change the name as next. Next. Whenever I change the name, you can see in the object navigator, automatically it changes. But it, still in the label, the same name is there. So what I do is, I will change in the label, whatever in the label, I'll go to the label, I'll reduce here, I'll go to the label, then I'll change the label name as next one. This way I'll give one. I'll change the color. You can go here 4 color, I can go light, whatever it may be, this color, and dark background color should be very, very dark. This way I'll give color. Now I will give tooltips. Tooltip is what? Tooltip is next record. I will give the next record. That's all. Now you can see that. Now I will compile and then run. We'll compile and run the push button now. So you can create any number of push buttons based on your application needed. We can create more number of applications here. You can see the push button is available in the background color and the color. Now I will execute here. So now I want a next record. So I will put it. Here you can see the next record is coming. The tooltip is coming. Now I'll go next record, whatever it may be, because it is not coming, because I won't write the trigger. That's why it's not coming. Now what I will do is, I will go and I will write the trigger for this push button. What trigger I want to write? When push button press. So it's not coming. So if I go here, the triggers, you can create the trigger in 3 different levels. This is called item level trigger. This is block level trigger. This is called form level trigger. This way we can create 3 level of highest priority is form level. Next is block level. Next is item level. So here now I will go, I'll create when button press trigger. When button press, I will write when button press trigger trigger, win button press. This trigger I'll write the win button press. I'll write what next underscore record. This is what my trigger. I'll compile. What I will do is here better. I'll change the color. Color is not good visible here in the things. That's why what I will do is I will change the color, dark color. I will give the red color is there. So I will change it to background color red. So I will give four colors more like green, dark green. Okay. So now I will change the color. So already it is available. When button pressed, I write the trigger. This trigger I have. Which trigger? Here in the built-in trigger, can you see lot of triggers are there. I wrote next underscore record. This trigger. So now we can see in the compilation, compile and run the form. You can see the next underscore record. So once I am not writing the trigger, there is no action. There is no use of the button. The button is available, but there is no action at all. So now I can go. So I can execute. Now you can see the tooltip is coming. Now I can click next record. So I'll go previous one. Next record. This is what the buttons we are using. We can remove all this toolbar. For example, commit, saving button, and execute query, and previous block, and previous everything we have using the built-in trigger. We can remove in our application, own application design. We can create a button. That is the advantage of creating the button. That's all. This tutorial, what we learned is nothing but we know how to create the buttons. We know how to create the name and label, color, tooltip. Tooltip is available. Tooltip is coming where? Tooltip is coming within a window. That's what we are seeing. Within a window. That's all the end of the